Let's start with our recipe. First, we're going to measure our dry ingredients, and I'm going to start with our flour. We are going to use 3 cups of all-purpose flour or maida, whatever you have on hand. So this is 1 cup. And this is our 3rd cup. We're going to add 1.5 teaspoons of salt. We're going to add 1.5 tablespoons of sugar. We are just going to mix this. I am using 1% milk and I'm just measuring 1 1/4 cup. Now we are going to warm this milk for 30 seconds. It is now our milk is warm. I like to just check how warm the milk is. Yes, and it is perfect. It's not too hot, it's not cold. It can be on the colder side, but the milk should not be hot, otherwise our yeast will die. Here I have 1/4 cup of butter or 1/2 stick of butter that I'm going to cut into small pieces. So let's go ahead and warm our butter for 30 seconds. Now butter has not completely melted, but it is nice and soft. Now you can use 1/4 cup of olive oil instead of butter. The results will vary slightly. You will get more of our regular bread, but the bread will still be nice and fluffy. So to our dry ingredients, one last ingredient that we are going to add is yeast. This is the yeast that I use. It actually has 3 names listed on it: bread machine, instant yeast, and rapid rise. I always have a bottle handy. We are going to add 2 teaspoons of yeast to our flour. Now I'm going to add the butter and incorporate it well into our flour. Now we are going to add the milk. Here on, our process is same. You will use the yeast, sugar, and milk portion to this. This dough is slightly stickier, so it takes a while to actually knead it. Use a KitchenAid mixer, but many friends don't have KitchenAid mixer or a Cuisinart processor, so I'm showing this recipe by hand. But if you have, I have a KitchenAid mixer. I also use my bread machine sometimes to knead the dough. Okay, now as you see, this dough is really, really sticky. My hands are sticky, but now I'm going to set the timer for 7 to 8 minutes. And for the next 8 minutes, we are just going to knead the dough really well. What we are going to do is push the dough, pull it back, push the dough, pull it back. Just keep on doing this. See, now my dough is coming together. It's almost there, but not yet. But my hands have become clean now. But we are going to do the same process. We're going to push it, pull it back. is my hands are clean. My parath is almost getting clean, but we have to knead it for a couple more minutes. The other way you can tell that the dough is ready is when you poke it in, it will spring back. Just push it, pull it back, and there goes our timer. And see, our dough is nice and soft. If you're done kneading your dough, I just want you to watch this one step, because this step is this. Now this dough is big and it is really easy to understand. What I'm doing right now is we are just rolling the dough in such a way that we are tucking it down. See, I'm kind of pulling from top and I'm tucking it under. What happens is when you do this, when you go on tucking the dough below, you get a nice smooth top, and that is what we are going to look in our second step. But I'm going to transfer it to my KitchenAid mixer. And I'm just going to oil it a little bit. Just half teaspoon of oil so that it doesn't stick to it. And I'm going to drop this dough in the container. Make sure that you apply oil on all sides. We are going to cover it with plastic foil. So now I have placed the dough in a tall container and it is going to sit there for an hour and 45 minutes. Or until the dough has doubled in size, whichever is faster. Either hour 45 minutes or the dough has doubled in size. So I'm going to keep my dough container in the oven and I'm going to turn the light on. So here goes our dough in the oven. I'm not turning on the oven at all. I'm just going to turn on the light. You can also keep it on a countertop, that is fine. But I find that if you just cover it with a kitchen towel, it has gaps and the dough might become dry. You're going to need one egg and a fork to beat our egg and a pastry brush. If you don't have egg, you can use milk as I had suggested in my post. And we are going to need, I am using a basic cookie sheet today to bake our pav. But this is really the ideal pan to bake the pav. This is a 9 by 9 inch square pan. So let's crack our egg and beat it. I like to use just the egg white. Feel free to use whole egg. What egg does is it will give us that nice golden color. If you are using milk and butter, the color will be slightly lighter. But if you are using egg, you will get that perfect golden brown color. So I'm going ahead and I'm going to use just the egg white, but you can use full egg. That's optional. And set this aside. We are just going to beat it lightly. Now we'll punch our dough down. This is my dough. We'll just punch it down. We are just going to make 12 equal size balls. 12 same size dough balls from this. And we are going to just lay them on the cookie sheet that we have lined with parchment paper. So here are my 12 balls that I have made. I mentioned about rolling the dough and tucking it in. That is what we are going to do now for every ball. We are just kind of pulling it down and we are going to tuck it. So we're going to pull the dough down and tuck it. Just pull it down and tuck it. When you do that, you get that smooth top, and that is really the secret so that you don't see the cracks on the dough. So all I'm doing is I am pulling the dough, I'm stretching the dough and tucking it down. Pulling the dough and tucking it down. That's all I'm doing. So our 12 buns are ready. We will place them close to each other. They should just barely touch each other. Here is how my tray looks. Now all I'm going to do is I'm going to apply the egg wash to it. The reason we keep them close to each other is because you want to see the ladi, right? If you keep them at a distance from each other, you will see they will puff up as individual buns instead of a one ladi. So when they are together, they will form the shape of a ladi, which is they'll stick to each other when they are rising and when they are baked. Definitely your oven should be empty and the light should be on. We are not going to turn the oven on right now. We are just going to turn the light on of our convection oven, and we are going to place these buns in the oven for second rise, and we are going to give, say, let's do 1 hour. So now I'm keeping these in the oven. So this is my pav after 1 hour, and it has doubled in size and looks good. We are now going to preheat our oven at 375 degrees Fahrenheit. You should use the center rack of your oven. And these are our puffed buns. Now we are going to bake these. We have already preheated our oven at 375 degrees Fahrenheit, and I'm just going to pop this in the oven, 375 degrees Fahrenheit and center rack. We are going to heat it, we are going to bake the pavs for approximately 20 minutes, but we'll check at around 15 minute mark. So I'm just going to check on our bread. Now my pav already looks like it has been baked in 12 minutes. So I'm going to remove it from the oven. Here it is. I go by the color of the bread normally when I'm baking bread, because that's the perfect indication that your bread is done. But I'll suggest that everybody's ovens are different. So wait until you see nice golden color on the top. Something like this. And after the bake, the bread has been baked. I'm going to apply butter to get that nice shine on the top. The bread is very, very hot, so when I apply the butter, it actually bubbles up on the top. So I'm just kind of wiping it so that it looks nice and shiny. So here it is, my pav is ready. So with this, the 20 minutes of baking is done. And I really hope that you and your family enjoy the pav. Like I said, do post photos and share your thoughts and comments right here. And hopefully we will meet again here with Ukdi Che Modak. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.